Hello everyone, today I will be showing you how to connect crystal oscillator. So first let's see the circuit diagram. We need SL100, 47 kilo ohm, 8.2 kilo ohm, RC S2.2 kilo ohm, RE 560 ohms, CE 47 microfarad, coupling capacitor C1 C2 as 0.47 microfarad, and for tank circuit we need two 22 picofarad capacitors and one 2 MHz crystal. Instead of 2 MHz, we can even use 3 MHz or whatever the crystal which is available in your laboratory. Now I will show you how to connect this crystal oscillator circuit. Here I am using a NPN transistor. As we all know, a transistor has 3 terminals: base, collector and emitter. Here we have a notch. So the terminal which is near to notch is emitter, and if I move in clockwise direction, the second one is base and the last one is collector. So emitter, base, collector. For easier identification, what we have done here: emitter is yellow color, base blue color, and the collector is in red color. So first I will take only the base terminal. So in my left hand I am holding the base, so I am fixing base here. And this is collector. Collector I am connecting to the upper side, and the base, sorry, emitter I am connecting to the down side. So I repeat, this one is base, collector, and yellow is emitter. Now coming back to the diagram, now I have to connect R1, 47 kilo ohm. So I have taken a 47 kilo ohm resistor. So this one should be connected to base terminal. So one end of the 47 kilo ohm is connected to base, and the other end is connected to 12 volt VCC. So now I am connecting to the common point. On the later stage, I will be giving 12 volts to this common point. So next I will be taking 8.2 kilo ohms. So I have taken 8.2 kilo ohms. One end of 8.2 kilo ohm is connected to base, another end is connected to ground. So R1 and R2. Now I will be connecting RC, that is 2.2 kilo ohm. So one end of 2.2 kilo ohm is connected to collector. So I have taken, that is 2.2 kilo ohm. So one end is connected to collector, another is connected to common point, where I will be connecting plus VCC in the later stage. And the last resistor I will be taking here, that is 560 ohm. One end of the 560 ohm is connected to emitter, another end is connected to ground. Now we are using a RPS, regulated power supply. So plus VCC is connected at the top end. So if I connect it in the top end, that means all these points will be getting the common supply, that is 12 volts. Similarly, the negative is connected to downside, that means all these lines will be getting ground in common. Now I will be connecting this CE, that is 47 microfarad. I have taken 47 microfarad. Here it has two leads, one is lengthier one, other one is shorter one. The lengthier one is positive, short one is negative. So the positive one is connected to emitter terminal, and the shorter one, which is negative, is connected to ground. Now I need to connect two more capacitors, that is C1 and C2. C1 is connected to base terminal, and other terminal is connected to empty side. And similarly, C2 is connected to collector terminal, as shown in this diagram. Now once all these things are over, I am coming back to circuit diagram. So this one is a tank circuit. Here we need two 22 picofarads and one 2 MHz crystal. So in between two 22 picofarads we need to connect one ground. Now I am taking, now I will be showing you how to connect this one. So I have taken 222 picofarads. So this is 22 picofarad capacitor. So I have connected 22 picofarad one capacitor and the other one I have connected here. So 222 picofarads, and where 222 picofarads are combining, I am connecting it to the ground. So this one is grounded. Now one end of the 22 picofarad, it should be connected to 0.47, and similarly this another end should be connected as a feedback to C1. Now I will be using those two connections. Now this one is C1 and this one is one side of 22 picofarad. Now I will be taking another connecting wire. Now this one I am connecting to, one end is connected to C1. I have connected to C1 and this one connected to another 22 picofarad. Now I am taking a 2 megahertz crystal. Now there we can clearly see there is mentioned 2 megahertz. So instead of 2 megahertz, you can also use 3 megahertz, 3.5, whichever is available in your laboratory. Now this 2 megahertz crystal is connected between 222 picofarads. So one point of 22 picofarad, another point of 22 picofarad. So between those two I am connecting this particular crystal oscillator. Now probe. So as we all know, the positive terminal is red color, negative is black. So output we are taking from C2 and the other terminal is connected to ground terminal. So we have used,
okay,
we are using channel 1. Instead of channel 1, we can also use channel 2 in CRO. Now I'm switching on power supply. Now we'll check the output. So now we'll see the CRO. So we are getting a clear sinusoidal wave. So if you want to remove the ripples, then instead of 8.2 kilo ohm as R2, I can use a pot and I can remove this noise. I can smoothen this particular sinusoidal wave. Now let's find out what's the frequency. Now here we can clearly see. Now I'll just take it as a reference. So we can clearly see, starting from this point, 180 degree, then I'll be moving here. This is 360 degree, one complete cycle. So one complete cycle is taking one box. So that one I have to multiply with time base. So time base here it is 0.5 microseconds. So we are moving at the last, this black line. So 1 into 0.5 microseconds. So the time is 0.5 microseconds. Now if I inverse that one, 1 divided by 0.5 microseconds, frequency will be 2 megahertz. So 1 divided by 0.5 microsecond is 2 megahertz. The crystal what we have used is also 2 megahertz. So both theoretically and practically this crystal oscillator experiment is matching. So one thing I want to mention here, if you want to remove the noise, or ripples, if you want to smoothen that sinusoidal wave, instead of this 8.2 kilo ohm, we can use one 10 kilo ohm pot between base and the ground. Then we can tune that one so that we will get the smoother sinusoidal wave. Instead of that 8.2 kilo ohm, now I have used a 10 kilo ohm pot between base and the ground. If I use this one and tune this one, then I will be getting much more smoother waveform compared to the 8.2 kilo ohm fixed value what we have used earlier to this one. Thank you.